spent the whole night before praying that the schoolhouse would just blow away. I didn't really think God would be listening. If I'd have known he could hear me, I'd have kept my mouth shut.
Mama saw Pa's tractor stalled out in the field. And usually man, the storm was coming in. Sure enough, those clouds came rolling in. Blood red. But Johnny and I had planned to skip that day. He was out in the field, waiting for me. I couldn't get to him. Pa would have belted me if he knew. Most boys weren't even in school no more, but Pa had a funny idea that if I stayed, I'd be worth more later.
I couldn't find him. I couldn't see very far. As I tried to make my way home, I saw Miss Field hanging onto a fence post for dear life. I tried to grab her arm to bring her along, but she just looked at me like I was a ghost. She wouldn't budge, so I had to go on without her. I went cursing Johnny for not waiting for me. Normally did wait for me, but that was a different kind of day. School ended just as early as it had begun when those dust clouds came rolling in.
Looking out that day, the clouds just gobbled up the whole world. Our farm, the Davis's farm, the schoolhouse, the main street, cattle, chickens, and tractors.
Johnny.
Everything.
Gone.
Isn't this amazing? I can't believe we're going on this adventure. Down the whole mother world. All the way to California. Ain't this something, you guys?
Sure.
Why are you so down? Come on. Sunshine.
Gotta go see if my pony's any help. Excuse me.
Why is she so down?
She did just lose her brother. Show some respect.
I know. I didn't mean nothing. But anything anyone ever does around here is mope around. Sure, life's rough. We got no money. We got no land. Well, it ain't worth anything. But we got this hero, Delilah, and she's gonna take us to the promised land.
You talking about that old jalopy like it's some stallion or something. Nothing but a beat-up old car or pawn Mr. Davis bought from the Andersons. Probably don't even work. She just forget it all and ride the rails.
Nah, she's a rival beauty, ain't she?
Think the dirt has traveled to your brain.
Maybe, or maybe I'm the only one seeing things clearly around here. Well, I ain't gonna let you all sound my mood.
Come on, I'll help you attach the chicken box.
What's wrong, Char?
Wanna leave.
Won't be home here in a day or two anyway.
Donald! Don't tell her that!
It's the truth. Bank's coming to knock down our house and your house. Got no choice but to head out, Charlotte. But don't worry. I'll protect you from any roaming packs of coyote or any wild beast that might be hiding out along the mother road.
No, please. Please don't make me go. Don't listen to him. He's just trying to scare you.
I ain't. Just trying to have a little fun. Listen, when I say I'll protect you, I mean it. I'm giving you my word here. Besides, you'll like California. You get to breathe real clean air.
Our paws will have so much work when they get there. They won't know what to do with all the money they'll be making. In 1 year, we'll be rolling in it.
What's that mean?
That we'll have so much money that we'll be able to live like kings.
And queens.
Your Majesty, I see you have forgotten your slippers again.
Yes, Seventh Girl, fetch me my slippers and my golden harp. I wish to hear a song.
Seventh Girl, oh Seventh Girl, I'm ready to be fed.
Your meal, milady.
Don't you dare, Ida. Gotcha! I gotta do everything myself.
Come on, Charlotte, let's go. Paul's waiting. You're gonna sit next to the suitcase in the back. See if you can fit. Shirley, your pa says you gotta hold the rope for the mattresses.
And where are you gonna be, Miss Bossy Pants?
Up front. navigating with our paws.
Just hold your horses. Why do you get to sit up front? Only the men should sit up front. You go sit with your little sis. I've got this.
Do you? Because you can place in the back. That's from your paw.
Went out of an orange colored sky.
Flash, bam, alakazam.
Wonderful, you came by. I was humming a tune, drinking in sunshine.
When we first set out on the road, down Sweet Old Route 66, we held our breath. I was in the back keeping everything together, cussing every rocking bump we drove over.
I was on the side, holding the ropes and the matches didn't fly away. Hands are holding on so tight, and fingers are bleeding. Felt like Oklahoma running from my veins.
I sat with Charlotte, pulling back her hair and holding back her hand as she let go. We hadn't had a stitch to eat, so the only thing left inside of her came out of dirt.
I sat up front with the men, helping Guy Pop and Mr. McGee. My hands were holding on to the front ropes, making sure nothing got loose. I could see Johnny in the mirror. And every mile that we drove, the image of him kept getting smaller and smaller, until it was nothing more than a speck of dirt.
We wound along the rocky path, over small springs and through deserts, the hot air smacking me in the face. I should have sat up front with the men, leading the way. Not stuck back here riding along the bender.
We slept to the side of the road. We washed our clothes in the nearest river we could find, If we could find one, that is.
I made the food. Made sure to use our rations sparingly. Never knew when we'd get any food again.
On the second day, our car died out. Both of our paws had hiked to the nearest town. They spent the next week looking from job to job in order to get money to repair the car. The rest of us just sat and waited.
And waited.
And waited.
I wanted to go with them, but Pa said I couldn't leave the girls alone. The open roads are a dangerous place for women and children. That's why I was there, to protect them. But the truth was, he still saw me as a boy. Well, let's show him.
That was the longest week of my life. Just camped along the side of the road, only some coffee beans and a few potatoes to eat.
I saw another family drive by.
That. Three mattresses up on their car. They were the richest people we saw.
As we watched them, they stopped and stared at us for a moment, as if trying to see what kind of people we were. After a while, their pa came looking after our mom. He told her none of us had one. He thought about it, and then asked us if we watched the girls for him anyway. Well, they went off to get some work. They shared a meal with us in return.
On the road.
Look who's talking. You're almost singing into me.
Quiet, Myrtle. When Pa comes back, I'm going to tell him about the bread you took from the car.
Extra bread?
Think I didn't notice? Give it here.
Don't know what you're talking about.
You got extra food?
Excuse me, boy, but please keep out of our business.
All you girls have done since your Pa left you is squeak louder than a bunch of mice. As the man in charge here, it is my responsibility to make sure that we're all fit. No offense, but I can't go on eating coffee beans and potatoes.
We already shared a meal with you.
That was it. Don't be greedy. We're keeping rations too, you know.
Just said you had extra. So if you got the bread, girl, you better show me.
We could just split it.
Betty, spit that out. Don't hurt her.
Don't worry, I got this. A little moist, but still good.
You lunatic, I could have choked.
Could have, but you didn't.
I'm telling my pa, when he gets back, he's gonna beat you.
If he comes back.
That brother of yours certainly has a way with the ladies.
Guess you could say that. I'm hungry again.
Me too. How you doing, Charlotte? Charlotte?
She's burning up, Elsie. They better get back here soon. Elsie, we got nothing to give her. Nothing to. Elsie, what are we going to do?
She's just tired is all. Let me see her. Charlotte. Charlotte. Charlotte, look at me. Come on, Charlotte. Please. We spent the next few hours just hovering over her, willing her to get better. Those three sisters did some sort of dance, saying they used to know Indian folk who knew magic or some such stuff. To me, it just looked like a bunch of hooey. It felt like forever until finally Donald's Pa came back. Ours didn't. Said he was gonna ride the rails and meet us in California. Heard about work, two towns over. So we had to go on without Pa.
When we got to the mountains, there was a road that was mighty steep and twisty. Couldn't get going or make those turns with all our stuff on that rickety old thing. So, Pa and I stayed up front. Charlotte was in the back. Shirley, Elsie, and Ida had to take all the furniture off and go by foot. What they couldn't carry got left behind, so there went that mattress I'd held so tight that my fingers bled.
After all the swerving was done, We got back in the jalopy and rode the rest of the way down the mountain. I'll never forget when we finally got down the mountain and saw the valley. Greener than anything else I had ever seen. We made it to California, yay! We all started crying. Even Pa. Donald refused to let us see his tears, but I knew it felt like the rest of us inside. All I wanted to do was bury myself in all of that green. Then we passed the town. It said, no jobs. Mr. McGee didn't flinch. It said, just because people get lazy and come to the first town they see, don't mean nothing. So we went on, and the next town, jobs taken. Mr. McGee still didn't flinch. I wasn't worried yet, but then in the next town.
It wasn't the no jobs that got me. It was the no okies and the looks we got as we passed on by. Nothing but cold stares and the devil's chill running down our back.
But we had to stop. We needed something for Charlotte. Finally, Papa got a tip. He was off from one farm to another, seeking anything, but only had work paying us than a nickel. That was when all of us came. So we did. We did it for Charlotte. And at the end of the day, all he gave us back was 3 cents. He said the price went down because more people went looking for work in the day. That wasn't the worst of it.
That nasty swine! I was rightly mad! So was Pa. So he said, we got a sick child. Can't you give us anything? Not even some food? Then the others heard Pa arguing with the man. They came closer and closer. The farmer got scared. He had a whole field of extra food, but didn't want to give no handouts. Just as the mob was forming, he and his sons set fire to their own field. Rather watch it burn, he said, than help you dumb okies. That was our welcome to California.
What about 2 chocolates and 1 licorice stick?
2 of each! You don't know how to share. Oh, and the eggs.
Oh, you wanted one too?
What are we gonna do?
Ask nicely.
Beg, tell him we can work for him to cover the cost.
The signs are no okies. I just wanna leave.
It's fine, just here. All right, now do me.
Gross.
Just do it. Fine, I'll make a deal. You can have 2 licorices. I'll get a pop and 2 chocolates.
This could be the last candy I ever eat.
You girls ready?
Ready for what?
To pay.
You work here?
Yep, every day after school, my pa owns it.
Gross.
Yes, we are ready. Our father has me down.
Okay, no problem. What's the name?
Mr. Cox.
Sure thing. Stop right there. Says your pa owes us money.
But that's impossible.
Yeah, he's dead. Then you don't have an account here no more, does he? In fact, you owe me
$10. $10? I think I'm gonna be sick.
Now look what you did. She's not well. And all over $10 that you know we can easily pay. We just didn't bring anything with us. How could we know? Please. My poor sister is so heartbroken. Can't you just let us go? You know we'll come right back with the money. Just let me take her home first. She needs the sugar.
I don't know.
Okies! Ew!
Hey, you, get out of here.
She put something in her bag. I saw it.
Did you think you would steal from my pawn meat? You okies are nothing but thieving trash.
Well, we'll just get out of your way. We'll be right back with the money. Good luck with your okie problem.
I'm sorry, please, sir. It's for my sister. She's very sick.
Think I'm gonna fall for that old line?
You just did!
Don't you go twisting things around. They ain't like you.
They just stole from you.
They have an account.
In debt.
I bet your pa's gonna be sore at you when they don't come back with that money.
He'll be sore at me that some dumb old Okies came into this store.
No, please, sir. It's for my sister. She really is very sick.
Then it serves her right. One less Okie to worry about. Now get before I get the police.
Yes, sorry.
Don't apologize to him. Don't ever apologize to him.
He's just working.
Most men don't come back until way after sundown.
Let us help you.
Be gentle. It's lined with real silk.
Of course.
Thank you.
What are friends for?
At least they didn't expect a tip. I hope they don't hurt me to handle.
They seem nice.
Where are they?
Low lives.
Thieves. Where are they? Don't try and hide them.
Hide who?
Those sneaky devils.
What? What did they do?
They stole our bread.
Right from under our noses. I hate it here. Knew we should have stayed in Oklahoma. First we met that nasty boy in the road. They leave us, and now this. I want to go home.
Are you sure they stole it? We could at least find out where the job was.
one whiff of it and you'd say you lost your sense of smell. Oh, poor little old me, I'm dying. I can't hear, I can't see, I can't smell. Deaf, blind, and dumb is all you are.
Those would be the last words you ever say to me. Then you'd be really sorry.
You ain't gonna die.
Mom and Pop did. Grandma and Grandma will too. They're too old to be living like this. I'm all you have. You better start being nicer to me.
Here.
You!
You thief and liar! I can kill you!
Elsie, Elsie, calm down!
It's the thieves again.
Me? Me?
You stole! I didn't!
Yes, because you got caught.
Let me at her! I'm gonna smack the smile off her face!
Someone please tell me what's going on here!
I will. That girl tried to steal from the general store, and I made sure she didn't get away with it.
I needed it for my sister. She's sick. She's dying!
I'm dying!
What store?
What does it matter? I can't help her.
It's too late.
Please don't cry. I hate it when you're sad.
I'm tired of feeling like this. I just want to be happy again. I don't even remember what that was like.
I know it's tough, but I'll help you any way I can. Your brother would have wanted me to.
Thank you.
Is she sane now?
Stop it! We've lost everything in the world. Our homes, her brother, my mom. Now Charlotte is sick. We don't need another nasty person breathing down our neck.
I'm sorry. I really am. Hear me, sister. Well, we know how you feel. Ruth?
Fine. If you want, we can have our grandma go look at your sister.
She used to be a nurse.
Really? That would be wonderful. Thank you.
My dress!
I'll go get her. Don't move!
I hope she can help.
I'll get whatever she needs for her.
Thank you.
Donald,
can I talk to you?
Talking to me right now?
I mean really talk to you. Normally talk to your sisters, but they ain't here right now, and I... Well, never mind.
Go on. Been through enough, right?
Right. Well, it's about a dream I have. I have the same dream every night. It never changes. First, the dark clouds creep in overhead. As it gets closer and closer, I can see it's a bunch of crows.
That's called a murder, dummy.
You can listen to my dream or just call me names.
Can I do both? All right, go on. You can tell me.
So this murder is headed right towards me.
Where are you?
Home. Well, what was our home?
The farm?
Yeah, home. Oklahoma.
That there's your first mistake.
What?
That ain't your home no more.
It'll always be my home. I'll go back there when all this is over and those dust clouds roll away.
Well, good luck. Hope you can find it under all that dirt.
And you like this place better?
No. You can breathe at night here. Don't have to sleep with no wet rags on your face. No Vaseline in your nostrils. Don't have to dust every chance you can get. Don't have to dig out cattle from the night before. You of all people should.
Should what?
Nothing. I just thought you'd be tired of losing things in the dirt is all.
Things? I didn't know he was just a thing to be lost. Glad to know that's how you remember him. A thing?
Forget it. Sorry. No, I forget it. Don't know what I'm saying.
I'll say. Do you miss him?
Who?
Who? Johnny.
Every day. He was my best friend. We had some grand plans for our future. Now I guess I gotta do them alone.
What were they?
You don't want to hear.
Oh, yes, I do. Please. I told you about my dream.
Did you finish?
No, someone wouldn't let me.
So your crows?
My murder. They were headed right for me. They landed all around the yard. Felt like a shock of electricity when they fell. I could hear the other clouds rolling in. I couldn't see nothing, but I could taste it in the air. I'll never forget that taste as long as I live.
What? You mean you don't like eating a mouthful of dirt?
Oh, well, of course, Donald. I love the taste of lamb grits. Mm-mm, just like Mama used to make for me.
Well, I can give you a spoonful of it now, if you're homesick.
You do, and I'll rub it in your eyes. So your turn. Your dreams. You and Johnny.
Hoped you forgot.
Please, I want to hear them.
Fine. Well, we were either going to ride the rails to New York City or here to California to make our fortune.
And what?
Well, that's the thing. We could never agree on one thing. Was automobiles or digging for gold or businessmen who sold, I don't know, anything really.
Well, that's not a very specific plan.
Well, I guess we didn't know what the heck we were talking about. It was just a pipe dream, anyway.
Still make your fortune.
Nah, no such thing. Learn that right quick.
Oh, don't talk like that. Johnny would have hated it.
Yes, he would have.
So funny.
Nothing. It's between Johnny and me.
That's how you feel about it. I better go see if anybody's seen my Polly yet.
Sure thing. Elsie! He's coming back.
Hey, you have to keep up. I almost got caught on that.
But we didn't!
But we could have.
But we didn't!
Sometimes I wonder if you really are my brother.
Well, I ain't your sister!
Come on, I got one more place we can get up tonight. But with all that money, it'd sure be hard for one person to carry it all. Sure wish we had a third person to help. We could split it.
What are you talking about? I ain't splitting nothing with nobody. I mean, except you, sis.
What money? You hear of a job?
Oh, excuse me. But were you listening to my brother and I's conversation?
Not on purpose, but...
Eddie, I think we said too much.
Wait! Please! I can help! What kind of job is it?
What kind of job is it he wants to know? Why should we tell you?
Yeah.
Because I work really hard. Please, a friend is sick. I really need this money.
Oh, he has a sick friend. I think we should let him help with the job.
I don't. I said I don't want to split it.
And I said I think we should let him in on the job.
And I said I don't want to split it.
Don't mind him. The job is yours. You need to sit 10. Got it?
Yes, of course. Thank you.
Stop.
Hey, you!
What's the matter with you?
What's the matter with me? What's the matter with me? You're the one that left me and my sister stranded. We had no food, no water. Nobody ever came back for us.
I'm sorry, my sister was sick. We had to.
You had to, nothing. You could have taken us with you.
We had no room.
Was that furniture worth more than our lives?
Some people passed. One offered us a ride, but could only take one of us. So we kept on walking until our heels bled. And finally, we got to that great big mountain, and the folks said we could ride with them if we carried their stuff up, their furniture up the side of the mountain by foot. So we did, and they tried to drive off, but we jumped on and held on for dear life. Just went from caravan to caravan, like beggars.
I thought your pa was coming back for you. I really did. That's why we left you. I'm sorry. I bet he tried to find his way back to you. I bet he tried hard. Maybe he couldn't find his way back to you. Maybe he got there after you left and he's still there looking for you.
I bet he's...
We saw him a few times from here. He said he thought you all would look after us. Didn't have much to say after that.
Where are you and just sitting here anyways?
I'm looking for somebody.
Your pa never came back either?
He will. I know he will. We need him.
Thought that too. Turns out we didn't. My sisters and I, we have each other.
Elsie! Elsie!
Do you hear that? Those nasty girls actually came through for us. Their grandma's sharp and she's a record player. Says nothing cares better than sweet music in the air.
I can't remember the last time I heard music like that.
I told you things would look up.
Elsie, come on.
He's not coming back, is he?
Don't. Not you, too. He is. I know he is. But sitting here and pouting isn't going to bring him here any faster. Sean needs you.
We all do.
I gotta go find Donald. He has to hear it, too.
Charlotte? No. Charlotte.
Please don't go. Don't leave me.
Jails, not as bad as I thought. Get 3 square meals a day, shelter and town to myself. Sorry I left you all behind. I made a promise to protect you, and here I am, all laid up, probably living better than you all. Charlotte, hang in there. You're a fighter. Just like your big sister. Ida, Shirley, watch out for yourselves while I'm away. Mine, Pa. Elsie, I think about our talk. I hope we can have more to say when I get out. And Pa, I hope it didn't disappoint you much. I'll make it up to you. I'll prove you proud again. Hope this letter finds you well. Heck, hope it finds you at all.
I thought when we left, the dying would end. I thought, in the deepest part of my heart, that we'd be better off here. Maybe now she is. My baby sister. You start out life with a home and a family, and slowly it's all taken away from you. One by one. Your daughter until you ain't. Your sister until you ain't. So what's left? What are you when the crows are done picking you over? Nothing but bones. Soon not even, just become dust. Dust on an already dusty road.
Your love.